Hello and welcome to a quick look at the statistics menu on the Casio Prizm as well as linear regression. If you are new to Casio, you may not know how to navigate this menu screen. It's really quite simple. You can either press the number 2 to get right into statistics, that's a little shortcut, or you can just move over using this directional pad and then press execute in order to select statistics. Once we get into statistics, you'll notice that we have a number of lists. There are quite a few to choose from, but we really at this point only need list 1 and 2, so we are going to enter our sample data set into these lists, list 1 and 2. I'm going to put the independent variable values down here, and then the dependent variable values in list 2. So I'm going to enter 3, 4, 5, etc. up through 9. It's important that you notice that when you enter these data points, you want to be sure to press execute in order to store your value. If you do not press execute, it will not let you just arrow out of that cell, like you might be accustomed to in a typical spreadsheet program. Then I pressed the right arrow to move into list 2, where I will enter the remainder of our values. And there we have two lists of numbers that we now want to create a scatter plot of. If you want to make a scatter plot, that's a graph, and so you may guess that it's right here under our F1 menu. But if by chance you do not see this menu, a couple ways to get out of whatever menu you might be in: you can press exit a bunch of times, and sometimes that will bring you up to a main level menu. If that does not work, F6 here, which is right underneath the more options selection, F6 will go to more options and even further options and then back around to graph. So you can try that. Now that we have graph up on our screen, we'll just pick F1 right below graph, and we can graph three different types of graphs, three different graph settings depending on what you choose, or you could even do select to select two or three of those graphs to graph simultaneously. But at this point, we really want to make sure that our settings are correct. So we want to go into the set menu and press F6. Stat graph 1, which is the one we will probably use, is already set up to be a scatter plot. But if it were not, you could just scroll down and choose from these options. You'll notice option F1 is scatter plot, but we have XY line, pie graph. If you press F6, you'll see even more and still more and then even more and then back around to scatter plot here. So we'll press F1 for scatter if you do not already have it. Then you will want to make sure to set your list 1, XList, to be list 1 in this case, which I can do. It's already list 1, but if I needed to, you just press list 1, execute to set that. Do the same for list 2. We want to make sure frequency is set to 1. If it's not, you can just press this. And you can even change the mark type and the colors and so forth, although we're really not going to get into that at this point. Once we've done all of this, you can go back up and change that to stat graph 2 or 3 if you wish, but we're done, so we can just exit this by pressing exit to come up another level back to our main screen. Now that we've set graph 1 up to look exactly like we want it to, it's a simple matter of just pressing F1 to graph that, and sure enough, this looks like a very linear relationship between our dependent and independent variables. And we really want to do that before you do a linear regression. You want to make sure that it's justified. So in this case, we can see that a linear regression probably will be a very good fit to our sample data. So now we want to calculate a linear regression. And to calculate that, it may not be too much of a surprise that we're going to go to our calculate menu, F1. And we have a number of regressions to choose from, even more over here. But right now, we just want to do one in terms of x. Not x squared, which would be quadratic, or x cubed, which would be cubic, but just x for linear regression. Now, we have two options on the Casio, depending on your preference, depending on your instructor. It really depends on your situation. If you prefer ax plus b or a plus bx, I will use ax plus b at this point, but they both give you essentially the same type of result, just a matter of which is a and which is b. So ax plus b, and there we have it. We have our correlation coefficient, coefficient of variation, and so forth. But most importantly, for what you're interested in at this point is probably just the coefficient of a and the constant term b. Now, if we just press F6, we will draw this, and you'll see that it fits very nicely. If we want to take another look at this, we can just hit ax plus b again. It'll go into the same location, but now we can copy this if we choose. And if we copy it, it'll allow you to copy it into your graph application for later use, which sometimes is pretty handy. In order to copy it, just select where you want to store it. I'm just going to select Y1 and press execute. And although you don't see it anymore, it is there. But when you press draw, we will still just see this thin blue line, which indicates a linear regression. You can press exit a couple of times, and now we get back to the calc screen, or the calc menu, but also this defg, which stands for define graph. And you can go in there, and you can manually adjust whatever graphs you want, or you'll notice there is our regression information stored for you. So if you press draw, you'll notice one slight difference. It's a thicker blue line, and the reason for that is simply that within here, this is a thick blue line is how it's defined. You can change the format if you wish. But that's the primary difference that you'll see when you graph these, is your regression line will be thin blue, and any additional lines will be colored and thicker. And so there we have our data points. We have our line of regression, and again, if you want to reaccess that, it's just under calc x ax plus b. I hope you find that helpful.